Hey everybody, here we are again, the Pixie Rustic Flippers. We are out in Lexington, Kentucky today, and gonna hit the Goodwill circuit out here to see what we can find online and flip for a profit. We are at stop number one.
Let's go.
All right guys, so let's take a little bit of a look here. Got a record here. And the lady's name was Rusty Warren. She was hilarious. Way ahead of her time in comedy. Women weren't supposed to tell jokes and make the kind of comments that she did back then. You know, it was during the 40s and that kind of, for women, it was inappropriate and unexpected and all that kind of stuff.
What did I
found? Oh.
That old drawing pen, that's cool.
The green handles?
Green handles. They're supposed to be, I think, the harder ones to find. And I thought these were really pretty hand painted.
What are they?
I think they're just decoration, but they're hand painted.
Hmm. Is that going to do pretty well? All right, guys. Well, we're going to take a look around and see what else we can find. I'll get back with you in a minute. All right. They got a little pixie over here in their electronics. See if they got anything interesting. A little home theater system going on there, anybody? We must be getting ready to put more items out because a lot of their aisles are just kind of sparse, like. I'm really shocked about that. Yeah, the old Christmas stuff, you know. That's definitely full. Yeah. What's that?
We need another laundry basket to be back in the car.
No. Oh my gosh, are you really looking through the plushies?
He's cute. Yeah. You'll have to show our bin of plushies at the end of the video.
Yeah. You'll have to see our bin of plushies. It's pretty crazy. It's mostly Care Bears. Yeah, you guys, this is not a lot of not a lot going on, unfortunately. That I'm gonna take a peek at though. Alright guys, I'll get back to the auto minute. Alright guys, so pulled these out of the racks. Size large. Oh my Disney, they are Disney Parks. They are like official Little Mermaid leggings. Should be able to, with the prices being at $6.59, should be able to easily get $20, $25 out of these. They are in just immaculate shape. Then, of course, that's a little dusty, but and a pair of Athleta Tell Station Stash Flare Pants. I looked these up and they are going for between $30 and $40 depending on the color. So again at $6.59, that's pretty good. Found a Patagonia shirt, at least we're pretty sure it is. The tag unfortunately has been cut out of it, so we're not sure of the size.
Medium, but we'll see when we get home.
Yeah. So, unless you got anything else, we may end up just going ahead and checking out and heading on. Mm-hmm. All right. See you guys on the next one. Hey, boys and girls. I think we did okay at that last one. Here we are at stop number two. We're going to go in here and see what we can find.
Let's go.
All right. We're sorry checking out the case items up front. Unfortunately, they're wanting a little much for some of their items. This one historically is usually pretty crazy on their prices with their stuff in a case though too, so I kind of expected that. So see who we got here. Oh, okay. Take a look through the books and stuff. Oh Lord, you tell me you did not. Did you really pick that up?
No, it's sitting right there.
It was fun, guys. The Care Bear Whisperer.
That's right. Oh, Care Bears deserve a new one.
All right. We're going to take a peek around, guys, and see what else we can find. I'll get back with you. All right, guys, so looking through the old pants and workout pants and all that stuff again. Trying to see if we can come across any of our elusive Athleta and or Lulu. And not having a lot of luck, really. So I think I saw the missus going through the jeans a moment ago. We were taking a peek trying to see if she could probably try to find a pair of mother jeans, I imagine. So, we're not finding a whole lot in here. Unfortunately, it's a nice little place, but they just don't have a lot going on today. So, this will probably be it, and I'll see you guys at the next one. All right, boys and girls. So, we didn't record it, but we stopped at a local yard sale that we found, and I think we got some pretty decent pickups out of it. I mean, you know, nothing that'll sell for a ton, but we only spent $9 and should make like $80-$90 probably out of everything. So yeah. It's not bad. We are here at the Heartland Goodwill. And we're going to go in here and see what we can find to flip online for profit.
Here we go.
All right. So kind of walked in here now and take a look through the good old media section. See if they got anything for us to pick up today. Big Bang Theory. Such a good TV show. Well, it was, I guess I could say now. Seen a whole lot so far. Alright, let's go and take a look at some other places in here and see what we can find. Alright guys, so looking through the old pants section again for Lulu, Athleta, something of that nature. Having a ton of luck today. This one has been a little bit more slim pickings than I would have thought. Usually this one's pretty good when I come in here, but
Timberland size 7, leather. Look, except for the white part, look brand new, and I think you can clean the white part up, you know? The leather looks nice. Size 7.
Alright, so.
I'll get them, they're, what, $5?
It's not so hot today.
Well, that's what I thought. I mean, I
keep peeking through these and see if we can find anything. And like if I do, I'll get back with you guys. All right, guys. So, did a little digging. Had a glass jack and a pulpit. And you said that is what?
This is called a five-finger vase.
Five-fingered vase, as you can see. Found a couple, let's see, found a couple old Webkins. You know, depending on, of course, what they're asking, but they should sell for about $15 each. Granted, they would sell for a lot more if we had their codes, but.
And then a vintage needlepoint bell pull.
Bell pull. Is it literally attached to a bell and you.
I don't know, maybe. I mean, not anymore, but.
Yeah.
Obviously.
So I think that's all we're going to look for today in this one. I think we're going to get out of here, go get some lunch, and we will see you guys at the next one. So guys, as we were getting ready to leave, they brought a couple of carts. We found this Umbro Retro Wind jacket.
Windbreaker.
And
the kind that used to have the pants that went with it, you know?
Mm-hmm, yep. And it sells for about $40. And then walked by, and I kid you not, turn around a brand new Swiss Gear backpack with tags, and since there's no price on it, it will be a backpack price, so we're gonna go ahead and pick that up too. So okay, now I think we're off to go get lunch. Finally, I'm starving. All right, let's go. All right, so we left that as we were leaving that Goodwill, ended up finding a pair of Skechers tennis shoes that were in really, really good shape and need a little bit of cleaning, but brand new, they sell for $80, and sold comps on them I was finding around $40 to $50, so ended up picking those up. You'll see those in a wrap up. So we are here at the next Goodwill, and it's one of the smaller ones in Lexington. I don't know that we've ever really had anything produced out of here for us before, but we're gonna go ahead and take a look anyways. So
let's go.
Alright, so I'm going to take a peek here, boys and girls, and see what kind of electronics we got available to us. I'm going to take a look through these and see what exactly is here. Alright guys, so I've been going through with everything. I haven't really found anything yet. Like I said before, this store is not usually a big producer for us, so I'm not 100% certain that we're going to find anything this time. Looking through the plush, just coming across more of those Webkins, but I'm not finding anything either, so I think we're gonna cut it here and go on to the next. All right, boys and girls, here we are. We are at the Claysmill Road location, so we're gonna go on here and see what we can find. This one, it's been hit or miss, but sometimes when it does hit, it hits pretty good, so
we'll see.
All right, so here's what we managed to kind of scrounge up, and I think we actually might have done pretty good. This particular pair of Lane Bryant jeans, they're new with tags, and I think the price on jeans is $7.59. And I looked at used comps on it. I couldn't believe it or not. I couldn't find any new comps on it, but I found used comps between $35 and $40 on them. So I'd imagine I should be able to get closer to $40, maybe even $50 on them being brand new. Found us another pair of Athleta jeans. We have currently have a pair of these up for sale, and they are going for about $35. Then, these shoes, they are made by Puma, but they are Super Mario branded. Brand new, they go for $140. They are not brand new, obviously.
They're not badly used.
But they're not badly used either, really. The soles and the sides look like they'll probably clean up pretty well. We should be able to get about $35 to $40 out of them as well. And they are priced at, I think, $5.99, right?
Nope.
No? Oh, $9.99. Oh, we'll still make triple our money on it.
Super Mario.
And then we have these Brooks GTS, was it?
Mm-hmm.
I think there was a pair that was in better shape used that went for about $80. I think once we get these cleaned up, they should easily go for about $40, maybe $45. And I think we got a $7.99 sticker on them, so.
Mm-hmm. Not terrible.
Not terrible. So we're going to go ahead and pick all this up and get out of here, and we'll see you guys at the next one. All right, we're here at the final Goodwill in Lexington, and we're going to go to today. After this one, we're going to head back to Louisville and go to our favorite one. So let's go in here and see what we can find.
Let's go.
All right. Let's check out their media section as usual first. These little glass insulators sometimes can be worth a little bit of money if you get a certain color and certain manufacturers. I have to say this is, well, that's cracked there. I'd say it was about one of the cleanest ones I'd ever seen, but spoke too soon. Still here to, well, oh, it's back here. I'd say it's kind of a pseudo electronics. It's really electronics seem to be all over the place. So alright. Well guys, I'm gonna look through this, see what there is. If I find anything interesting, I'll get back with you. Alright boys and girls, here we are, last stop of the night. Our favorite Goodwill here in Louisville. We're going to go in and see if they got anything to let us buy and take home and sell for a profit.
Let's go.
All right, guys and gals. So, back looking through the old pants section again, trying to see if there's anything, you know, worth picking up. Yeah, our favorite Goodwill today is doing a little slim on the pickings. But as you can see, there's a lot of gaps in between the clothing. It's like that all the way around. I think they may have done a recent pull, I guess, of stuff that needs to go out that's been on the shelf too long. Or, well, in this case, rack. Because there are a few other racks and areas in the store that are like that as well, and yeah, but finding the name brands that I'm looking for particularly, there are good things here. So, I guess at this point, I am going to stop this and then look around a little bit more. And if I find anything interesting, I'll bring you guys back in. Thanks. All right, everybody. So here's a wrap up from that big old trip we did. So first off, this is that backpack I think I mentioned, but I don't know if I actually ever showed. It's new with tags. It's with Swiss gear. Then under it is an old dot matrix printer. I'm not sure how many of you who would watch this would actually know what that is, but that's printers in the old days. I don't know if it works. I have no way to really check to see if it works, so it will be sold as is parts, but it was only $5, and I've seen other as is parts for about $45-$50. So then we come across this it's Ninja Turtles, as you can tell there. Backpack. It's more sleeping bag. Sorry, it's more for like sleepovers and stuff. It's not one you'd really take and do, you know, camping with. But it's the old 1980s Ninja Turtles, which is really cool. This blanket here. What's going on with that one?
Ralph Lauren.
Okay. Mm-hmm. It's got the little silky edging all the way around it and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I believe you said that was going for about.
Almost 50,
okay. So then in the back we have these little decorations,
wall decorations,
the spiky things. So you just stick them up on a nail to hang.
Two rolling pins.
She was telling me that apparently certain colors on the handles make them more valuable than others. I don't have that information available right offhand, but that's kind of cool to know, though. These are some hand-painted wall decor. We don't know anything about the artist. I can't really find anything specific. So, you know, it's going to get kind of sold as a just general decoration, but they're still really nice. That right there is actually a Canon PowerShot camera. I was actually able to test it in the store because when they put it out, the battery was actually still charged in it. So I took a couple of pictures, zoomed in and out, did all that before I even brought it home to make sure that it worked, and it worked. So I saw that one had about $180 comp on it. And then, of course, you know, good old Pac-Man. Everybody loves Pac-Man. I've stuck batteries in it and tested it. It does work. It's a lot of fun to play around with. Texas Instruments TI-83 calculator. It actually has batteries in it already and does work. Unfortunately, it does not have the cover for it, though.
This is a Holland Delft butter dish.
Delft, yeah. And then
this is a pin trinket box or pin holder. You would store your sewing pins. And then just another trinket box that actually matched it. These are egg cuddler cups. I don't remember what
the maker.
Yeah.
And you said this was a.
This is a needlepoint bell pull.
It's really neat.
Or.
I haven't had a chance to look that up. I believe that it's a Fenton.
Ruffle edge
dish. We've had once before that looked exactly like that, but. You know, I'll do my research on it and make sure before we post it. This is that five-fingered vase that we were talking about earlier. It's really nice. The Jack in a Pulpit vase. Behind these, this actually surprised me when she picked these up. I didn't know that these were what they were. You want to tell them what they are?
They're Mackenzie Child candlestick holders.
Mackenzie Child. So anybody who knows anything about Mackenzie Child knows that the stuff's usually hard to find and usually very pricey. And we'll come over here.
Got that first.
The divided tray. It is porcelain, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely heavy and fragile. It clinks.
And a child's Raggedy Ann and Andy.
Bowl, plate, and cup.
Mm-hmm.
It's very cool.
Got it for $3.99, and I couldn't find any comps where all three were sold together from 1969.
Holy smokes. I didn't know it was that old.
Yeah.
Stack of pants, leggings, Various, you know, makers, Disney, Athleta, Lane Bryant, Lee's, Levi's.
Columbia Ski Pants
Bottom. Yeah, Columbia Ski Pants down there on the bottom. Those will probably just get put up until the winter. Yeah, I don't know that anybody would buy them in the middle of summer, but... Well, spring in this case, sorry.
Pottery Barn Teen pillowcase covers.
Yep. That is that retro windbreaker. Retro
windbreaker.
Yep.
And a UK zip-up sweater.
Zip-up sweater, yep.
Mm-hmm.
Let me go back here. And these are some Brooks running tennis shoes. They are actually in really good shape. They just need to be a little clean. These are those Super Mario Puma from Mario Sunshine tennis shoes we were talking about. The Skechers. I ended up picking up the Skechers. I don't think I got that on video. That was towards...
last second.
Yeah, last second down at the Heartland. And then, of course, back here from various locations, we have some more Steffies. The giraffe, the cat, the wolf, and the lemur are all the old Webkinz critters. Most of them go in the range of about $15 each. They were all picked up for 99 cents. Then our little Care Bear back there. Of course, my wife is the Care Bear Whisperer. And decides she had to save it.
No Care Bear left behind.
And she was $1.99. She'll probably sell for about between 10 and 15. She's one of the more modern Care Bears of, I think, 2017, something like that.
Something like that.
Found this Nerf Infinis gun. It has a barrel on it that holds, I believe it's either 25 or 30 rounds. And it does work. It's got batteries in it. And, yeah, actually, it's heavy. That's because of the batteries. Because it's like something like 6C batteries.
These are both Pottery Barn play sets.
A set of four in each one.
A set of four in each one. Obviously, these will put up till Christmas. But these would be good for summer.
Yep.
And then this big Breton tray. Be great for a coffee table
or something of that nature. Actually, I think we have something else in mind for it. We don't want to mention it right now because it's going to be a surprise for the channel when we get around to actually having it done.
And then you got this stuff up here.
And then, let's see, you said who was a
Brighton.
Yeah,
it's a Brighton
wallet kind of clutch thing. A Vera Bradley lunch bag. Nike hat, not a golf hat or anything, just general hat. It needs a teensy bit of cleaning, not much, more than anything. It just needs to get the dust and the pet hair off. So we found this New York Yankees. I was able to look it up, and I saw others for sale, but I couldn't get a definitive comp on it.
It's a kid's hat.
But it is a kid's size hat. So, you know, $2 at a Goodwill, let's just say $15, I think, is what I could probably get out of it. Then, I think, for me personally, this was the star of the show for the outing. As you can see, it says Disney. It is. It's a marble chessboard. And then the pieces. So you got the castle for your castles. Donald is your bishop. Goofy is your knight. Mickey and Minnie are your king and queens. Pluto is your pawns. Same deal for the gold pieces. We couldn't find a sold comp for it for a while. The missus, she found a sold comp on OfferUp. And it sold for $250 5 years ago. I have not been able to locate this same set at all anywheres, including on eBay or otherwise. So, I'm thinking that it's a very good possibility I could get easily $300 plus out of it.
Make our own price.
And make our own price. So, as always, I invite you to tell me what your favorite item was that we found. And to also take a moment and hit that that subscribe button to follow us. And then make sure you hit that notification bell so you'll know when the videos go live. So until next time, get out there, have fun, thrift away, and we'll see you guys on the next adventure.